Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to use Gemini AI API with JavaScript Node.js. So let's get started. So the prerequisite is going to be you must have Node.js installed on your system. If you don't have, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top. So now let's get started. First thing, just Google Gemini AI Studio and you'll be getting the official link from aistudio.google.com. Select it and make sure that you are signing here with your Google account. And here to the right, you can choose whatever the model you want. So we are having so many models available. The latest one is going to be Gemini 2.0 Flash, Pro Experimental, Flash Lite, and Flash Thinking. So I'm going to go with this 2.0 Flash model. And to the top, you'll be having this get code option. Click here, and here you're having the code for Python, JavaScript, Go, Android, Swift, and Dart. So we are going to go for JavaScript, and here we are having the code. So we can just copy this, and in the Visual Studio Code, just create a file. Let me go with new.js, and just paste the code that I have copied. So this is basically it, and we just need to add our Gemini API key. So I'm just saving it, and before we do all this, we need to install two packages. So first one is going to be this one, Google Generative AI. So we can just copy this and go to Visual Studio Code and paste it. And another one is going to be the .env, since we are going to add our Gemini API key in the .env file. This is also required. So two packages and just hit enter. And that's it. We have installed both of these packages. Now let's go and create our .env file and add the Gemini API key. So new file, and it's going to be .env. And let me just go here, copy this, put it here, equal to, we need to have our API key. So for getting that, go here in your Google AI Studio, and to the top you'll be having get API key. Select it, and here you're having create API key. Select it, and you're going to select the project. I'll just go with this particular project and just click on create API key. So once it is created, you can just copy this. And in case if you want to delete it, you can just click on the delete icon over here. That's up to you. Now you can just paste the API key like this. And now we need to access this API key in our code. So for doing that, we'll be using the .env thing that we installed. So it's going to be require, and you're just going to add this require.env.config. So make sure that you are just adding this particular line, okay? require.env.config. And we can just save it, and this is fine. We are getting the Gemini API key over here, and we are passing it. And next, the model, if you want to change the model, you can just go here again to the home interface, and if you select Flash Lite and click on get code, you'll be basically having this model over here, or else you can just copy this thing and put it over here. That's up to you. And next, we are here, we are having some parameters. We're having temperature, max output tokens, basically the creative level. I guess if you put temperature 1, it will be more creative. Lesser the temperature, it will be more focused on the answer, less creative. Max output tokens, total number of words in the response that is going to give. This is the response type. And here we are having the start chat. So here we are passing our parameters, response parameters, and chat history. And this is going to be the place where user is going to input, and we are just console logging the response. So everything is inside this run function. So this run function basically runs the code. So in case if you are using an API, you can just put this run function inside it and get the user input as a argument to the function. You can just pass it like that. So now let me just go here and give a simple prompt, essay on AI. That's it. I'm not going to go with too complex. So we are good now. I will save it. And for running it, it's going to be node space your file name .js and just hit enter. So as you can see, I have got the response. So such a big response. And what if you wanted to control the max output tokens that gets generated? In that case, you can just go and change the value. So I will just go with 100 something. I'll just go with 100, which is so less. And now basically we will be getting very less response. So here we are having such a big response, right? So just going to save it. And now again going to rerun the exact same code, but this time we will be getting only two paragraphs, not even two paragraphs. Like this is a heading and we are getting only one paragraph. So in case if you want to get less response, you can just try adjusting the max output tokens, and you can also just try adjusting these in case if you want. And also in case if you want to know more about this Gemini API, you are also having the API documentation option over here. So you can just select this and you can just try going through the code that they're having for Python, Node, and also other capabilities. They're having text, they're also having vision, audio understanding, long test, thinking, structured output, image generations, and I guess image generation is paid. As you can see here, image gen 3 is only available on paid tier. So if you want to see that, you can also check that out. So overall, it's good fine tuning embeddings. You can just read this out full of, you know, full of knowledge. And yeah, you can just check it out, guys. And do check the playlist of my channel also. I've done a lot of videos in AI tools, Gemini AI, OpenAI APIs, and other programming videos in general. Check the playlist, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.